गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज हेलोफाइट्स, दैट इज प्लांट्स ऑफ सैलिनिटी हैबिटेट्स। सो फर्स्ट वी सी व्हाट आर हेलोफाइट्स। ओके, सी हियर, हेलोफाइट्स आर द सॉल्ट लविंग प्लांट्स दैट ऑकर नेचुरली ओनली ऑन सॉइल सॉल्टी वाटर। दे ग्रो इन सॉल्ट मार्शेस और इन इश्यूरीज। इन सच प्लेसेस द सॉइल इज सेड टू बी फिजियोलॉजिकली ड्राई बिकॉज द वाटर प्रेजेंट्स इन इन द सॉइल इज नॉट अवेलेबल टू द प्लांट्स। देन वी मस्ट नो the types of halophytes. So according to Arming in 1909 recognized two types of halophytes as littoral swamp forest or mangroves and Chamnophilus halophytes. These are the two types of halophytes. So first type, that is littoral swamp forest or mangroves. These forests are extensively occur in all tropical seashores, estuaries, especially on flat muddy shores where the water is relatively calm, as in lagoons, inlets, estuaries, etc., where soil is flooded with water either permanently or at the time of high tides. The littoral swamp forest form characteristic vegetation known as the mangroves or mangrove formation in tropical and subtropical areas. Example, rhizophora. Then second, that is Chamnophilus halophytes. These plants grow on sand and rocks on or stones. They can called false mangroves. Example, Ipomea biloba. Then we must see that adaptations in halophytes. Halophytic roots is the first point in their adaptations. So in relation to the halophytic roots, first we see external adaptations in roots and then internal adaptations in root. So first we see external adaptations in root. In salt marshes, the soil is waterlogged and the roots cannot get oxygen. In such cases, example Avicennia, Soneriata, the plants possess negatively geotropic roots that grows above the surface of the soil and are called nematophores or breathing roots. Nematophores or breathing roots are found only in mangroves for gaseous exchange. The nematophores are characterized by the presence of numerous lenticels, which serve to absorb air that goes to the root below through the intercellular spaces in the cortex. In some mangroves, example that is Rhizophora, stilt roots are developed for additional support because as they grow in loose muddy areas and develop in pyramidal shape. Okay, then we must see internal adaptations in roots of halophytes. Roots are of two types, aerial and subterranean. A typical underground subterranean roots in transverse section shows several layered cortex made up of star-shaped or stellate cells connected with each other by lateral arms. Cortical cells have peculiar thickenings due to lignin deposition. Some cells filled with oil and tannin. The steel is contracted and there is a broad pith in the center. The outer pith cells are thick-walled and possess pitted thickenings of lignin. Pith cells along with the thick-walled xylem elements form a strong central zone of mechanical tissues. Pith cells contain tannin and oil. Then next point, that is internally adaptations in aerial or steel roots. So see here, the cortex is lacunate and reduced. It is made up of one type of cells, and in lacunate there is no thickening ridges in the cortical cells. The cells are rounded. The cells contains oil drops and tannins. H-shaped sclerites are present in cortex. Numerous secretory cells are present in pericycle. The stele is broad. The inner face of xylem groups are strengthened by the presence of strongly lignified sclerenchymatous cells. The pith is well developed and possesses oil cells, arid tin in cells. Then next point, that is halophytic stem. So first we see external adaptations in stem. First external adaptations, morphologically the stem shows regular characteristics like mesophytes. Stem is hard, branched, bark is hard, can be peeled off maturity. Then next point, internal adaptations in stem, which are showing as follows. There is a thick cuticle even at young stage. Epidermal cells heavily thickened, almost scaries filled with oil and tannin. Hypodermis several layered of heavily thick walled cells. Primary cortex possesses a number of lacunae cells, of which are thickened, filled with tannin and oil. Crystals of calcium oxalate are also present in the cells. The lacunar cortex is strengthened by the presence of H-shaped which occurs singly in the outer layer of primary cortex. The inner cortex possesses groups of branched sclerites that give an additional mechanical strength to the lacunate cortex. Endodermis is clearly defined and its cells are packed with starch grains. The pericycle is sclerenchymatous and is made up of 3 to 4 layers of cells. Pith also possesses lacunae and H-shaped spicules. Cells of pith also contains tannins. Vascular tissues are well developed. The vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral, enlarged, and open. Then next point, that is halophytic leaf, which are showing external as well as the internal adaptations. So first we see the external adaptations in leaves of halophytes. Most of the halophytes are succulents. Their leaves are evergreen, thin or thick, small and leathery, with water storage tissues. The halophytes show xeromorphic characters. Vivipary is also an important adaptive characteristics of the halophytes, as seeds cannot grow in dry mud. The physiologically dry soil is rather physiologically wet. For the halophytes, vivipary is a type of germination in which seed germinates within fruits while still attached to the mother plant. It is found in some mangroves, example rhizophora. Then next point, internal adaptations in leaves. See here, the halophyte shows a xeromorphic characters, especially succulents. In Avicennia, the leaves possesses a submerged epidermis, water storage tissues. A number of pelted hairs are also present on the lower epidermis. These hairs function as a salt glands and excrete excess of salt present in the absorbed water to the exterior. Immersed halophytes are strictly xerophytic in their features, palisade tissues being prominently developed, and often the epidermis is highly cutanized. Typical leaf of rhizophora shows the following anatomical features, such as cuticle very well developed, epidermal cells are heavily thickened and may contain कैल्शियम ऑक्सीलेट क्रिस्टल्स। ओके, थैंक यू।